Sketch-based elements are those that are created by entering into sketch mode and defining a boundary to create the extents of the element. Floors and roofs are the most common examples of sketch-based elements. Let's take a look at how this works. On the Architecture ribbon in the Build panel, I'll click Floor to activate the Floor tool. And when I do, Revit goes into sketch mode. The easiest way to tell that you are in sketch mode is by the large green check mark and the big red X that appears here in the contextual ribbon. Now, when you are in sketch mode, really the only thing you can do is define a sketch. And so sometimes people enter into sketch mode and then they don't know how to get out. So if you press escape, so I'll press escape a few times and nothing's happening other than I removed the selecting boundary line. You can click modify and nothing happens. And so a lot of times people will try to go to another ribbon and activate another tool and they're all grayed out. And the reason is because they are in sketch mode. And so the only way to exit out of sketch mode is to either finish edit mode, which completes your sketch, or cancel edit mode, which cancels out of sketch mode and discards any sketch lines that you may have made. So for example, I'll click cancel edit mode, and now we're out of sketch mode and all the tools are available again. All right, I'm going to activate the floor tool again. And now, once again, you can see we're in sketch mode and there is a draw panel and I can select either boundary line, slope arrow, or span direction. But you want to start with the boundary, so boundary line selected by default. And then there's a draw gallery with several tools that can be used to sketch the floor boundary or the boundary of whatever sketch element you are creating. So I'll select line, and then I can simply click and I can see a magenta sketch line. And then there are listening dimensions for the length as well as the angle. And so you can move the cursor in any direction to create that sketch line. So I'll simply click 2 points here. And notice that when I clicked the second point to create the ending point of the first sketch line, another sketch line was created, and that is because chain is selected here in the options bar. So be aware of that option. And if I want to create another sketch line in another location, I can press escape to end the current segment, and then I can move somewhere else and begin sketching a line. I'm going to press escape again, and now I have this open boundary. And if I try to finish this sketch by clicking Finish Edit Mode, I'm going to get an error. So this error dialog appears, and it states that lines must be in a closed loop. So when you are creating a sketch-based element, pretty much every sketch-based element in Revit, there's just a couple. Railings can have simply a line, and you create a railing along that path. But pretty much everything else, you need a closed boundary to define that element. So when you get this error, you can click Quit Sketching, or you can click Continue. So in this case, I'm going to click Continue so that we can continue editing this sketch. And I'm going to select Start End Radius Arc, and we'll just sketch a random boundary here. And this time, instead of creating a nice closed boundary with no intersecting lines, I'm actually going to intersect these lines here. And I'm going to press escape. Okay, so we do have a closed sketch here, but we have intersecting lines that are overlapping. And so now when I try to click Finish Edit Mode, once again, I get that error. So my point here is just to show that you need a closed loop with no intersecting lines. So I'm going to click Continue, And then let's use a modify tool here. And I'm going to clean that up. And now I'm going to click finish edit mode. And we have a random sketch, but you can see we created a floor. So once again, when you are creating a sketch-based element, you can use the tools in the draw gallery. And most of the time, you need a closed loop boundary with no intersecting or overlapping lines. But we'll show one more example. If I activate the railing tool, and I'm going to create a railing path, I'm going to use line here, and I'm just going to sketch a line, and then click finish edit mode. And this time that is an exception to the closed loop with sketch-based elements. For railings, you can simply draw a straight line or any shape, and it doesn't have to be a closed loop, and you can create a railing along that path. So those are elements that are created by entering into sketch mode, and they're referred to as sketch-based elements.
Howdy! Thanks for watching. If you'd like more free content from Click to BIM, please like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We also have affordable subscription options at clicktobim.com, where you can access all of our videos. We also have an amazing search feature that allows you to search through every single word in all of our videos to help you quickly find the answers to your questions.